is worthy to be.
My name is Ikechukwu Adike. This is my second time to be in this church. I'm from Anambra State, but my parents stay in Lagos here. I'm a student of Nandazikiwe University, Oka. So in Oka, I used to watch Pastor on cable television, MITV. And I love his compulsion as everything, his teachings and everything. I had this challenge when I was, that should be 2004. I had a dream, and this dream, that it was this girl that was my girlfriend then. She came and shot an arrow to me. Ever since then, I became sick. But me looking at me, you wouldn't know I'm sick. The sickness I'm talking about is what doctors have not been able to define. I go to hospitals, they will tell me different stories. This doctor will tell me another story. And the sickness is that I can't bathe with cold water. If rain manages to touch me, if I'm outside the rain and rain touches me, it seems as if they poured hot water, they poured pepper, and my body begins to itch me. This thing continued for so many years. It started 2004 precisely. I went to school, I did my first degree, did my master's, this thing continued. But as I was pastor on television, something convinced me that if I can just be here, that I will be healed. So on Wednesday, I came back. On Wednesday, I was at home. I wasn't doing nothing. I took my BlackBerry phone and googled his name, because I don't know here for the first time. I stayed at Barua. I googled his name. I saw something that Google brought out. I was looking for the address. I saw the address. I was at home. I have not bathed for some days because of the fear of the painful agony I passed through each time I bathed with cold water. And I don't like bathing with hot water because it makes my inside body very hot. So I have not bathed for almost 3 days. So that day, I just took my shirt, wore my trouser, and came here. When I came quite early. I saw a guy, I asked him, is it the church? He said yes. I came inside and I saw a pastor that is reading in worship. He asked me who brought me. I said, nobody brought me. He said, God brought me. I said, amen. So we sat down. I was just waiting for the pastor to come out. That once I hear him speak, I will be healed. Hallelujah. So he came outside, he was teaching, I was shaking. I said, God, devil was giving me excuses, maybe because of the AXE. I said, no, I've been, my house have AXE. This is not AXE issue, this is the anointing. It was just that I was shaking. And I stay in Barua and I don't stay late nights. So the time was going, devil was telling me, remember, they will lock your gate to total time. I said, devil, if it means me sleeping here, I'm going to sleep. But when this man prays for me, I will be healed. I don't know. It's not because of anything, but I have this inside conviction about it. Then, after prayers, we shared the grace. He said that if he still needs prayers, we should wait. I was surprised. I have seen senior pastors, the way they conduct their prayers, once they are true, they will run inside their office. But this man stood and said, if you still need prayers, come outside. I was shocked. I was surprised with that calm of mindset. Then I waited. I was here. He said, we should come front. I sat down here. He was praying for a lady. They told him, he said, I should come. I said, God, this is my hour. No matter what the devil wants to do. Then, I did not tell him anything. He started praying for me. As in, I've been under ministrations. I have fallen under anointing. But this one was something different. I felt so. If you have known me before, you think maybe somebody paid me to do this. This is my second time of being here. So it's not about anything. It's about what God did in my life. You have not been under what I've gone through. As in, you can't bathe where you want to bathe until never blink light before you can boil water and bathe. It's something big for me that God has done for me. So he called me out, laid his hand on me. I said, manifesting. But when I knew that something had gone out of me was when he said, every spiritual horse, every spiritual wife tormenting this man, leave now. Immediately he said that, I fell under the anointing, but not just falling. I knew that something had left me. So I went, but he didn't know anything. He didn't know. I left. I was happy. I was singing. I boarded a bus to my place. Me that I usually have difficulty praying for 1 hour. That day I prayed for 7 hours. I said, God, is this a magic? I have done so many things to be able to pray at night. They say I should not eat much at night. I've tried all those things. Nothing is working. But just within 5 minutes of a man of God praying for me, this thing happened. That is the first testimony. Then he said I should come back on Sunday to see him. I said, okay, no wahala. Then this morning, that was on Wednesday. On Thursday, I was still scared of betting. I said, God. But on Friday, I betted. Nothing happened. On Saturday, I betted. Nothing happened. I was thinking, maybe it's a coincidence. In fact, I really forgot that I had that sickness inside of me. Then this morning, he said I should come by 10 o'clock. I said, okay, by 9 I will be here. But our transponder got spoiled. Devil came and said, ha, don't even go and try betting, no, because if I bet, it will take me 1 hour for me to come out of it. So if I want to go to somewhere around that 10, I will bet around 8. So that I'll be able to, you know. So this morning, devil said, you wake up late, which means if you bet now, 1 hour, time has gone. So I was there 10 o'clock. After 10, I was still scared. One voice said to me, go and bet. I opened my shower, I betted, and nothing happened. Hallelujah. I called my mom. I said, Mom, please come. Because my mom will always see me. If I have friends that came visiting me, she will lock the door by herself so that my friends will not see me. Then she came and said, She came and said, my son. My mom came and said, my son, are you not scratching yourself? I said, Mom, no. That I went to a place and this man of God prayed for me. And ever since then, these things have stopped. My mom says it's a lie. My mom said, okay, that what you will do is this, I should go and bet again. That for her to confirm that this thing after, because she has spent money in hospitals. She has gone to places. We have gone to native doctors. We have gone to many places. My mom says, okay, my son, go and bet again. Let's confirm that this thing really happened. She came and stood at my bedroom. I was betting. And my mom saw that this thing, I finished betting, I cleaned myself up. I said, Mom, this thing has disappeared. So, church, this is how over 9 to 10 years sickness inside my body was disappeared. Praise God.